now, Australia-based Filipino actor Mark Baguio stars with Chris Hemsworth in the latest Netflix film, Spiderhead. For more on his breakout role, we are joined this morning by Mark Baguio himself. Hello, Mark. Good morning from Manila.
Good morning.
All right. So, congratulations. This is arguably your breakout role. But first, tell us, who is Mark Baguio? Can you share with us your acting background and journey? Has acting been the dream since day one?
Yeah. So, I kind of started acting when I was about 8 years old, when my parents put me in this little community production called Ambassador Popoy. And it was run by a bunch of Filipinos, and we were making a little play that helped raise money for villages back home. So that was kind of my first introduction to acting. And ever since then, I really enjoyed doing it. Like growing up, I watched a lot of, you know, film and TV, obviously. I did a lot of high school productions and stuff as well. And I went to drama school, and now here I am.
8 years old, stardom young, right? It's nice to know that the Filipino community in Australia is well alive. So let's zero in your latest project, sci-fi thriller Spiderhead, now out on Netflix. Tell us what's it about, and as well as, you know, how you landed your role, who is also named Mark.
Yes. So Spiderhead, which is out on Netflix now, it is a location which is kind of like a state-of-the-art jail, where prisoners are given specific freedoms in exchange for scientists to test mind-altering and emotion-altering drugs. I play Mark Verlaine, who is the right-hand man to Steve Abnesti, who is played by Chris Hemsworth. And we kind of test drugs on all these inmates. And one inmate in particular, Jeff, who is played by Miles Teller, kind of starts to see the facility for what it is. And that's what the movie kind of follows.
And actually, I've watched it. It's just that I don't want to say something that would spoil it, you know, for everyone else. But how was it working with the likes of director Joseph Kosinski, Miles Teller, you know, from Top Gun, both of them, and of course, Chris Hemsworth, you know, acting alongside him? How did it feel?
I mean, to begin with, it was really nerve-wracking, just because it was, it's kind of my first, one of the first things that I've ever done on screen. I've done a lot of stage before, and, you know, to be playing opposite Chris Hemsworth, Miles Teller, to be directed by Joe Kosinski, to have Journey Smollett, like, in the room as well, it was really daunting at first, but
I could imagine.
Yeah, I kind of eased into it as we went, and the more I started doing it, the more I was learning so much every single day, just talking to everyone and just watching everyone work. So yeah, it's been a great experience.
And Mark, we know this isn't really your first film, right? You've also been on TV shows before, but how does this experience differ?
The previous kind of things that I did have been such small little roles that they kind of pop in for a scene and have a few lines. And I did that, you know, I did two projects before this one. This is the first time that I had a pretty meaty, substantial role that had a big arc.
I know.
And he has a big kind of emotional journey and conflict that he has to deal with throughout the film.
And Mark, how does being a Filipino affect, or perhaps help, your career as well? How do you frame or present yourself with every character you're given? We know from Instagram that you were born in the Philippines and you migrated to Melbourne at 4. Would you still say that you're in touch with your, you know, Pinoy roots?
Yes, I like to think that I'm in touch with my Pinoy roots. You know, I found an ube latte, and I went,
an ube latte.
You know, and you know, I try to make as many Filipino friends in Australia as I can. There is a big Filipino community in Australia. I mean, everywhere that I go to, there is a big Filipino community. So it's always nice to find. And in terms of how it kind of plays into my acting, I think I look very much Filipino, you know?
And you do.
Every character I play is going to be, well, sometimes, you know, I've played other races, and But I think I try to bring as much of that into it as possible. I think how I work is very Filipino. You know, I like to bring as much joy into everything that I can, but, you know, I work really hard. So, yeah, it plays a lot into how I live my life and then how I work.
Just for the record, I even haven't had ube latte.
Yeah, it's a Filipino-American thing here. I've never seen it in Australia, but every time I see ube, I get really excited.
What can you say about Filipino representation in Hollywood, you know, as compared to before and now?
I mean, before, I didn't really know of anyone. Or it wasn't as talked about before. You know, I grew up with Dante Basco, who did, I think he was in Peter Pan, one of the Peter Pan films, but I didn't know at the time that it was Filipino. You know, I had Her Majesty Lea Salonga herself, you know, growing up. Mm-hmm. But now it's, Filipinos are much more visible, you know, across different types of entertainment. You know, I look to like Manny Jacinto as a big inspiration, Jacob Batalon as well, Olivia Rodrigo. So it's really exciting.
And lastly, Mark, why don't you invite our viewers to watch Spiderhead, which is now out on Netflix? And maybe could you tell us what's next for you?
Well, sorry, I don't really have anything coming up next. But I do have two films, a film and a television show that I'm a part of called The 12 and Lonesome that you can check out now. But right now you can check out Spiderhead on Netflix.
All right. That's really exciting things ahead for you. Congratulations again, Mark. We're all very proud of you.
Thank you.